Okay, we're going to look at a tripod and a ball head from the folks at ProMediaGear. And you can see here, this is something that you don't see very often. I'm using that heavy-duty ball head as a way to level the fluid head. Instead of having one of those half bowls and fooling around with that, I just threw the fluid head right on the ball head, and it holds it fine. I leveled it up, and then I tightened down the ball head, and it doesn't budge. It holds it very secure, so I can just throw my fluid head right on top. Now, here I am unboxing, and I wanted to show you everything that you get with it and what it looks like and share some of my initial impressions. I really do like the tripod. There are a couple of things that could be better, but all in all, it's an absolutely fantastic tripod. One thing I do like about my enduro tripods, believe it or not, is you can loosen all the legs at once and simultaneously let them all drop out by gravity, extend, and then tighten them. It's very quick. These you have to loosen it and then pull it out. It won't drop out by gravity. So that's just one little thing, a few seconds here and there, extra time. Now you can see there is a set bolt in there, and I'll show you how we use that to tighten down onto the ball so the ball doesn't twist as an anti-twist measure. Most high-quality tripods have that, and there are some goodies that came with it. Now here's the ball head. This is the BH1 ball head, and it is fantastic. A lot of the reviewers rave about how well-built it is, and absolutely all these items, the tripod and this ball head, are exceptionally well-built. Now one comment that some of the reviewers made is that this isn't quite as smooth as a typical ball head. Like if you want to try in a pinch to do some panning with it, which I can do with my ball head, one of my ball heads on the Enduro, in a pinch I can when I'm shooting a video, I can kind of pan up and down with it, and it can be very smooth. This is not quite as smooth as that, and it's just evidently from the design that it is. There are trade-offs in everything in photography, right? So in this case, we get the one knob operation and we get the amazing radius of travel, but it is not quite as smooth as some of the smoothest ball heads out there. Now that said, I love the ball head. I'm absolutely going to keep it, and it's not something that you would normally do, want to pan or tilt with one of these. Normally you'd use a fluid head for that sort of thing anyway. So And as I demonstrated in the beginning, I can put my fluid head right on top of this puppy and use it right on this. I was going to put the Kirk disconnect, quick disconnect on here to be able to switch the ball with the fluid head, but I decided that I'll just forego that, and instead I'll just put the fluid head right on top of this ball head because it's strong enough to hold it in place even when I've got putting some pretty good torque on it with that fluid head, with some resistance. So there's the Kirk quick disconnect system, which is really cool. I do have it on some of my tripods, and I have a review here on my channel on this. It's a pretty cool setup. So if you want to use like multiple heads and so forth with your tripod, you just go ahead and put that plate on your ball head, and you put that receiver on the tripod, and it just works great, and it is very solid. So you know, once you clamp that down, it's not going anywhere. So that is something you can use. I decided at the end of the day that I'm not going to use it on this particular tripod. I'm just going to leave this ball head. It's going to live on there. And then if I want to slap the fluid head on top, I can still do that. So I have a lot of flexibility here because this ball head is so strong and it can level very easily. There's a level right on the top. And as I showed you at the beginning, I can very easily level the fluid head using the bubble that's built into that and make sure that it's level, lock it down, and then it doesn't budge. I tested it with some pretty good drag on it and it didn't budge that ball head at all. One of the big benefits of this ball head is once you get your camera situated and you lock it down, it's there. It doesn't drift. It doesn't, you know, some ball heads you lock it down, it kind of drifts a little bit when you lock it down, but this one is just, you get it where you want it, you lock it down, it's right there. So, and by the way, there are those aluminum collars instead of being plastic or rubberized or whatever, they're aluminum, machined aluminum. this thing is just over the top, well built. So any minor little shortcomings that it has are eclipsed by the build quality and all the pluses of this particular tripod. So I give this two big thumbs up. I think that definitely a lot of the reviewers have said that this is the one to pick over Really Right Stuff. And I have to concur. I think they're right. I think this is the way to go. I'm surprised I'm saying that, because Really Right Stuff makes some awesome Really Right Stuff. But this thing, I think, takes it to another level. And it's just, it's gorgeous as well. It's just a really nice piece of kit. And there's that set screw that you can use. Screw that into the ball head so the ball head won't twist on you. You get a very solid connection between the ball head and this tripod. It almost all becomes one. So again, two big thumbs up. Hit subscribe and click the little bell, and you cannot go wrong with Pro Media Gear. Thanks.